to the Midnight Cafe. Are you alone tonight? Well, I've come to the right place. This is your first time here. Okay. Oh, no, we're open exclusively at night. Now I can assure you we're not vampires. Or do you look undead to you? You want me to prove it? Claws. Okay, well, those are more of a style choice. Here. Feel my pulse. See? Definitely a living and breathing creature, just like everybody here. Now, we open at night because about 4 or 5 miles from here is a huge car part manufacturer, and the second and third shift workers are our main target group. Nothing quite as relaxing as a cup of coffee or tea and a slice of delicious cake to wind down after work, or a little breakfast before work. There's no such thing as vampires. Oh, but I heard there's a virus going around, and it's said to be deadly. So you should be careful not to catch it. Well then, my name is Allie, and I'll be your server today. Would you like to be seated in our upstairs lounge area? It's very cozy. Okay, great. Well then, follow me. I'll lead you to your table and get you a menu. You can go ahead and browse this before deciding which of our delicious treats you would like to indulge in. I'll go ahead and light this candle for you. Beautiful atmosphere tonight. Oh, while we're at it, let you enjoy the beautiful night air. It's my favorite. Oh, and since this is your first time, if you need assistance with ordering any desserts or beverages, I can walk you through our menu, tell you a little bit, or a lot, about everything we have. Yes, of course. There we go. As you can see. We have some wonderful coffee, tea, and cake selections. All of these are absolutely indulgent. Let's just go ahead and look at the coffees, some of our most popular choices. We offer a variety of espresso drinks, such as Americano, which is just a watered-down espresso. Lots of people can't really handle the bitterness of an espresso. Overseas, it's actually customary to order an espresso or a cup of coffee, a small one, with a glass of water, because it does tend to dehydrate you. Then we have a cappuccino, which is a cup of foamy milk with an espresso shot. If that's not quite foamy enough for you, we also have a latte macchiato, which is a lot more milk and a lot more foam with the same espresso shot. We have, besides espresso creations, hand drip and French press coffees. All of the blends are selected bring out their best aromas through each of these processes. They're all blends of Ethiopian, they're all listed here, Honduran, Nicaraguan, Costa Rican, Brazilian, Cuban, and Madagascar coffee. We also have a little fancier, probably more exotic coffee drinks, such as a classic mocha. Yes, that would be chocolate infused coffee. Yeah, typically taken with milk. We have Vienna coffee, which in place of the milk that you would put in most coffee drinks, is just topped with whipped cream, making it extremely rich and delicious. That's my favorite. We have Irish coffee with whiskey and cream. We have an eggnog latte, which is, as the name suggests, eggnog with an espresso shot. topped with hot milk. Also a little bit of nutmeg. We have an affogato, which is an espresso shot over ice cream. It's technically a dessert, but it's caffeinated, so we still list it under coffee. And then we have Thai coffee, which is flavored with cardamom and sweetened condensed milk. Yes, it's quite hard to find, but tasty nonetheless. Oh, of course, I should mention all of our coffees can be ordered with flavor shots. Those are just flavored syrups that we have and we have vanilla, cinnamon, caramel, let's see, what else? Oh, hazelnut, that's delicious in coffee, raspberry. I personally like to combine these two sometimes if I feel fancy. And, oh, chai. It's just a blend of various spices. Speaking of, our tea menu over here, we have a pretty big selection of various kinds of teas that I'm sure you would enjoy. Mm-hmm. We have several of each kind. As you probably know, teas, well, except for herbal and such, are all made from the same plant. It's on the same tea leaves. The different varieties are a result of different kinds of processing. For example, white tea is the least processed of them all and has a very mild, very gentle aroma. And we have it unflavored or in three different kinds of flavors: lavender, rose, orange cream. Sweet and delicious. Then there's green teas. This one has a more bold, citrusy aroma. There are lots of different kinds, but we're not a specialty shop. So ours is just a blended green tea, and you can have it unflavored again, or with lemon, jasmine, or mango flavor. The next kind is Wulong tea, which the flavor profile of Wulong tea varies a lot depending on how exactly it is processed and even how you steep it. Ours are on the sweet side and they come either unflavored or flavored with ginger, orange blossom, or pomegranate. You can't really go wrong with any of these. They're all absolutely delicious. As for the black teas, which are probably the most commonly found, we have breakfast tea. And this is a blend of different kinds of black teas from Assam, Ceylon, and Kenya. It's commonly enjoyed for breakfast, or with breakfast rather, which is where it gets its name. Oh. I need to warn you though, not to drink black tea on an empty stomach, as that can cause nausea. We also have Earl Grey, which is another tea blend flavored with bergamot, which gives it its very fine citrusy aroma. It's a rather sharp aroma, but a lot of people really like that. We also have it flavored with vanilla or even chocolate. Yes, ground cacao beans make for the chocolate flavor, as well as a tiny bit of vanilla to trick your tongue into thinking you're drinking hot chocolate. All of our black teas can be taken with milk and sugar, or honey, if preferred. Then, here are our rooibos teas. That's one of those that are not made from tea leaves. It's also called red bush tea. It is completely caffeine free, so you should have a caffeine sensitivity. This one will be no problem. It can be enjoyed by anyone at any time. We have that one flavored with vanilla and orange, which makes a really, really delicious combination. We also have that one as a chai. Yes, which means there are different spices added to this, such as cinnamon, ginger, pepper, and cardamom. Oh, and cloves, to create a unique spicy flavor. You can add these spices to rooibos or black tea or even herbal teas and call it a chai. These can also be taken with milk or just on its own, though a little bit of sweetener is recommended. We also have just cinnamon flavored rooibos tea or whichever you prefer. And then for herbal teas, we have the biggest selection of herbal teas, consisting of rosehip, which is technically a fruit, but let's not be picky with the categorization. We have peppermint, always a classic and very nice on the throat. What I love about peppermint tea is that it can be enjoyed in cold and warm weather. Peppermint on its own is a cooling plant. It cools your body, but it also has this association for many people with the Christmas season. And, you know, candy canes flavored with peppermint, peppermint lattes. Peppermint everything. We also have a chocolate chai, which is a little bit different. This one is a spice tea made with sweet wood, cacao beans, and cinnamon. Yeah. Oh, I can assure you, it tastes exactly like chocolate. This blend of spices does something to your taste buds that will blow your mind. Then we have ginger tea, brewed from fresh ginger root and served with honey or sugar if you prefer. We have chamomile. This one is popular among elderly people. It has lots of benefits. It's antibacterial and antiviral, and it gives you beautiful glowing skin. We have eucalyptus tea, in case you should get a sore throat. You can have a cup of this and feel a lot better after. We have nettle tea. Yeah, it's an uncommon one. It's a little hard to find compared to the others. And anise tea, which is treat nausea and stomach conditions. Yeah, you can think about that. So, ready to hear about our amazing cakes? So, first one, as you can see here, is carrot cake. Traditionally an Easter dessert, we think it should be everywhere, all the time. So we have it on our menu year round. Some people might not be fond of the idea of putting carrots in a cake, but there's hardly anything more delicious. Besides grated carrots, this cake also contains walnuts, or sometimes pecans, and various spices, such as cinnamon, nutmeg, ginger, and cloves, to give it its unique warming flavor. It is topped with a cream cheese frosting. Can never go wrong with carrot cake. It's the most underrated of the cakes, if you ask me. Next is our apple hazelnut cake. You may be familiar with apple cake, which is just a sponge cake with an apple and cinnamon topping. The apples are sliced into wedges and arranged in a round pan in kind of a swirly or flower design. Then topped with cinnamon sugar, and our adaptation of this classic cake is that we prepare the batter with ground hazelnuts, and also when greasing the pan, where you would otherwise use flour to coat it so it doesn't stick, we use ground hazelnuts as well. It gives it an extremely aromatic cake. And no, you cannot substitute any other nuts. It has to be hazelnuts. If you want to achieve this uniquely round flavor, no other nut will do. Then we have a cinnamon swirl coffee cake. Again, our adaptation of a classic coffee cake, which is a wonderfully moist cake with a coffee-flavored glaze on top. And we also stir some cinnamon sugar swirls into the batter. Yummy. Moving on to the more fancy cakes. There is opera cake. And this one is a layered almond sponge with layers of ganache and coffee buttercream. Yes. It's lots of layers, and it is topped with a layer of chocolate. The almond sponge is soaked in coffee. It's a rather sophisticated cake. We also have red velvet, possibly the most popular chocolate cake available. We use beetroot to dye our cake, which makes it a little darker, not as bright as commercial cakes. And it comes with a cream cheese frosting in the middle and all around. Oh, and we top it. It just makes for a really appealing slice. Then there's Black Forest cake, sticking with a chocolate theme. This is a very decadent chocolate cake with a cherry filling. The chocolate sponge is soaked with cherry water, which is, as you may guess, not water, and also not an essence, as you may know from rose water or orange blossom water. Cherry water is a spirit made from sour cherries. It can be quite hard to come by, so some recipes use rum instead, but you can get the real deal here. Cherry water soaked chocolate sponge with a delectable cherry jam and whipped cream filling. It is iced with whipped cream and decorated with maraschino cherries. Then German chocolate cake. This one is an especially sweet treat. Also a chocolate sponge. But the filling consists of a custard made with eggs and evaporated cream. Evaporated milk. Can you evaporate cream? I'm not sure. Whichever, that is absolutely wonderful. We cook the custard, egg custard, and then we mix in coconuts and pecans to create the original German chocolate cake flavor. Then we frost it with chocolate frosting just to contain the filling and topping. Tarte au chocolat. Tarte au chocolat is, as the name says, a tart. So it comes inside of a tart shell, and it's a very creamy, smooth ganache. It is our richest cake. This is the choice for chocolate lovers. It comes with a side of whipped cream to make your treat even more delectable. It's made with the finest dark chocolate. Because if you're gonna use chocolate, is a main ingredient in something, you gotta make sure you get the best you can afford. If that is too much chocolate for you, maybe you would fancy a slice of pound cake. Pound cake is a very simple yet delicious cake, which gets its name from the amount of ingredients originally used in it. This cake has been around for centuries, being made from a pound of butter, a pound of sugar, a pound of flour, and a pound of eggs. It used to be seasoned with rose water, orange blossom water, but nowadays we just flavor it with vanilla. Then another very traditional choice, we have Victoria sponge cake. It is often just referred to as sponge cake, which is what it consists of. Two layers of sponge, and in between is a raspberry jam and a whipped cream filling that is not usually frosted, and you can add some berries inside of it too, but for consistency purposes we stick to the original. Not the consistency of the cake. It's just that fruits are seasonal ingredients. So it would change depending on the season. Since we take care to only use the best ingredients at peak ripeness. And since we don't want to keep changing it and confuse our customers, we serve the original Victoria sponge cake year round. If you're a fan of berries or crumbs, we also have berry crumb cake, which is basically just a pie crust topped with berries and butter crumbs. It's in quite thin and simple cake, but nonetheless a delicious treat, especially in the harvest season. You can make this one with any kinds of fruit, apples, apricots, rhubarb, anything that's in season, and it'll turn out delicious. We also have a classic baked cheesecake, which should not be missing from any cake menu, made with ricotta cheese and eggs inside of a tart shell that is just sweet enough. I know, I can't stand it when they over-sugar a baked cheesecake. This one is borderline savory. It's just sweet enough to convince your taste buds that you're having a dessert. And we can serve it with a strawberry sauce, raspberry sauce, caramel sauce, or chocolate sauce, if you'd like it a little bit sweeter. And the last one on the menu is a classic. Another tart made with a lemony custard. There's nothing more to it, but it's the best combination you can possibly get. Especially if you're a fan of lemon flavored anything. This one is an individual little tart. We have these year round. So we also have daily changing specials. So if you know what you would like to order for your beverage, I can go ahead and prepare that for you while you browse the menu a little bit more, and I'll get you some samples of our daily specials so you can decide what kind of dessert you would like, okay? So, what will it be? Okay, wonderful. I'll get that ready for you. And I'll be back with everything in a second. Alright. Complimentary glass of water. This. organic cane sugar. You like. And now for the main part. Our specials today. They all look absolutely scrumptious, do they not? The first one. This is kind of an adaptation to the opera cake that I told you about. This is chocolate sponge, 4 layers, with buttercream between each, and on the outside, you might not be able to tell, but on both sides are sheets of marzipan, and it's painted with dark chocolate on both sides to contain the moisture inside the cake. We cut them into triangles because people like pointy food. And lastly, simple yet delightful lemon Swiss roll. We have different kinds of Swiss rolls often. We had strawberry, but we're all sold out. This one comes with a lemon flavored cream inside. Dust it with powdered sugar inside of a very moist, very light sponge, which is especially gorgeous on a warm summer night. So, if you would like to take a look. See any of these, or any of the ones from a regular menu? Alright. Well, gonna take this tea bag. Thank you. I'll leave you to it now. Enjoy the night and your treats. And if you should need anything, I'll be over there. Just call.